This is a little video on how to smoke a couple of meatloaves on a mini UDS. So the first thing we'll do is we'll set up a little bit of a base for the UDS using a couple pieces of brick. Okay, here's some of the materials you'll need. You'll need some wax paper to light the fire. That's kind of what I use. Some wood chips, apple or hickory or maple worked fine. I've got a jug of water and an aluminum pie pan for a bit of a deflector, heat deflector, lid. Charcoal, I use lump charcoal. Royal oak is kind of what's common here, easiest to get. I've put some charcoal in the chimney. I think that should be plenty, one chimney should do it. And I've set the basket to one side. We'll fill it up outside. The mini UDS is a little bit hard to, bit small, to put the charcoal in with the basket on the inside. So just one second, I'll light the chimney. So here we're just gonna light the chimney. Just grab a handful of wax paper. You ball it up and put it up underneath the chimney. Get that going. So it'll take about 10 minutes for the chimney to really get that charcoal going. Okay, so it's been about 10 minutes. It's heated up pretty good. So I'm just gonna pour the charcoal into here. A little bit more on top of there. Okay, that should be going pretty good. And so I've got this little thing here we can lift it in with. Do right now, I'll throw a few wood chips in, just a handful of apple should do. The sides there. Okay, so next thing we'll do, we'll put in our water pan. So I've got two layers of racks here. So on the bottom layer, we'll put our water pan. And this will heat, help catch any grease and catch the grease and keep the top rack, you know, where the meat is, from burning too much. So I'll just center that a bit. And here's my cooking rack right here. It just sits in there on those screws. So that's about it right now. We'll put the lid on, and you open the top lid, keep that open all the way, top lid, and down on the sides there's two little side things. So the fire, because the fire is going pretty good right now, I'll just open one, and this lets the air in. If the fire wasn't going very well, you can open two. There's one on each side. And okay, and then right here is your primary way of regulating the air into the smoker. It's this little ball valve right here. So what we want to do, we want to make sure that the temperature, the smoking temperature, goes from about 200 to about 250. So as the temperature rises up to past 150 into 200, that's when you should start shutting the air off. It's easier to bring it up to temperature than it is if it's too hot and trying to get it lower. So, like I said, when it starts to come up around just below 200, start shutting the air off. And so, ideally, when things are level, you would shut off both of the bottom valves, air intakes, and just regulate the air with this little valve right here. should run for a couple of hours on that amount of charcoal. Okay, so we'll start prepping the meatloaves.
Okay, so what we've done in advance, I've made a couple of meatloaves. So we'll just put those on the grill, in the smoker. So meatloaf, usually I think I bring it to an internal temperature of about, for ground beef, probably at least 160, close to probably 170, to be safe. And this will take about probably an hour and a half or so. So we'll just put the lid back on, keep that smoking. Okay. So I've just put the meatloaf on. I've got the vents open. Just bringing her up to temperature here. She's just under 200. So we'll just give her a moment. Sometimes it takes probably half an hour or so to come back up to temperature after you put the meat on. So partway through cooking, I usually just baste the meatloafs with a little bit of a barbecue ketchup mix, maybe say a half and half, just to give it a little bit of flavor. And then we'll do this again a little bit closer to when they're done. It'll give a little bit of crust here. Yeah, it's good. Put the lid back on. We'll check on it